the interest of the Americans now focused on splitting the country into two weak, dependent on American countries, and with points of conflict between the two countries along the border. One is in South Darfur, the area named Hufrat al-Nahas, this Nahas Hole, Copper Hole, and then Abyei, Nuba Mountain, and Blue Nile. These are future ignition points to the conflict between the two countries.
But the EU has indeed no policy and just following whatever the Americans are doing. I don't see any strategy in what the EU is doing concerning Sudan. I very much see that the EU is somehow allowing the US to lead and indeed to carve a separation of Sudan, which I don't think is necessarily in the interest of the people of Sudan, and namely in the interest of the people in the south. And this is also led by the reasons that there is oil in the region. The EU is also, in my opinion, wobbling on the crucial central question, which is bringing Bashir to the International Criminal Court.
Kdo v Evropi je tisti, ki odloča, veš, pomembne stvari? Kdo vodi Evropo? Kdo jo rula? Kdo jo resnično vodi?
Takole, tista le pumpa tamle noter, ki so kapeljce krvi z celega sveta, pa življenja so tamle noter. Pa se takole pogovarjaš, pa iščeš rešitev, pa se mem vozaš po jezi, ki svi stran gledajo. Kaj pa tebe?
To, da se šamane današnjega časa, ljudje, ki bi mogli svariti, ki so bili v vseh družbah od prvobitnih časov naprej, ne aktivirajo posvaritelji, da gremo v vojne, velike, velike, velike vojne. To, da ne razložijo družbi, človeštvu, da smo pred velikim umiranji in velikim trpljenjem in da je še čas, da bi se zbrihtali in spremenili stil, no, v katerem smo.
In Frankfurt we met Jakob Izil, a representative of Cinema for Peace. We asked him to help a new humanitarian organization called HOPE, founded by Klemen Mihalić after his return from Darfur, to find donors for cameras and water drilling rigs. Cinema for Peace supported the project and promised to help with fundraising, as well as promoting the film about the impact of video cameras in Sudan. Together with the third batch of cameras, Klemen and I also took satellite modems to Darfur so that video recordings could be uploaded to the internet. From now on, the people of Darfur themselves will be able to upload their own footage. Uploading images via satellite, particularly videos, is very expensive. We're therefore looking for sponsors to cover the data transmission costs. These are the first recordings sent to the world by our cameras. There are also pictures of 9 prisoners in Khartoum, taken by their wives in Kobay prison a few days before their execution.
You know this lady?
Yeah, I know this lady. She was trying to meet with a youth group of Orakashini camp to talking about what the problem what we have here and what kind of the problem also we facing in the inside Darfur. And I say that this, we have to make through the Silman Jamus to make human rights watch in Darfur the head topper of the Silman Jamus. What I said for that. Finally, she really liked to talk to me. When this war
Mia Farrow, the famous film actress and an ambassador for UNICEF, has been an activist for the people of Darfur since the beginning of the war in 2003. In 2007, she not only signed the petition for Jamous's release, but also offered herself as a prisoner to the Sudanese government if they freed him. When Darfur all but disappeared from the media spotlight and the secret extermination of Africans resumed, Mia Farrow went on hunger strike for Darfur to call attention to the fact that the war was still ongoing.
It's not a war. It's not two sides in battle over an ideology or something. It is an assault by the government in Khartoum upon the civilian populations of Darfur. And if what they call war breaks out again in the south, it won't be a war. It will be an attack upon the south by Khartoum. Make no mistake.
Mia Farrow will help us to take the water drilling rig to Darfur. Famous people from the world of media, and particularly actors, can do a great deal for humanitarian and political purposes. A clear example is George Clooney, who launched the Darfur Satellite Sentinel project in November 2010. The project involves the satellite monitoring of Sudan, with the satellite detecting and recording images of activities happening on the ground. The satellite camera shows battlegrounds, but it cannot show the faces of people, neither those of the perpetrators nor their victims. Our small cameras can do precisely that.
If you press longer, it starts filming. Now camera is filming. Now camera is filming.
Yes, yes.
So if somebody is attacking you, you can put the camera in secret place and put this button up, and camera will wait 20 days and automatically started
to take a photo
if somebody will attack him. These are these Chinese things which are now very interesting, because they can be like a watchman.
Do you think they will give us our rights?
No.
And after they didn't give us our right, what shall we do? We will be in peace.
If they don't, we shall do whatever we like. Of course, it will be the war.
Yeah. Welcome, welcome, FLS!
We are not agree with the government of NSP, the Muhtamar Watani, with the coming election. So we're supposed to be a new registration form for this coming election. So we are not agree with them. For this, we are starting this very big rally to show people that the government, they are not agree with us in this coming election.
The international community was not aware of the big protest rally outside the UN base in Kaouda, where the Nuba people demanded a new count and a new registration, which would allow the registration of their property in the land registry and give the Nuba the right to vote in the elections for governor. The Sudanese authorities are afraid that any such legal steps may lead to greater autonomy for the Nuba people. This would enable them to elect Abdelaziz, the SPLA commander in the Nuba Mountains, governor of the province, instead of Mohamed Haroun, the butcher from Darfur, whom the Nuba have accused of genocide. He is the current governor of South Kordofan, which is the administrative name for the Nuba Mountains used by the Khartoum regime. To add insult to injury, Bashir appointed Harun as Minister for Human Rights. My images and reports did reach the media, but what they published were abridged and far less critical versions of the reports I'd sent them. The Nuba warned, if those in authority do not respond, the stability of the entire region will be at stake. Not only the Nuba Mountains, but also neighboring Blue Nile Province, my next destination, where I was about to distribute cameras.
Javnomnenjske raziskave so pokazale najmanj 95-odstotno podporo južnosudancev za samostojnost, tako da lahko pričakujemo, da bo Južni Sudan približno v šestih mesecih razglasil samostojno državo.
Lepo zdrav v Sudan. Kot rečeno, se nahajate tam in čakate na izide referenduma. Kakšno je vzdušje v Južnem Sudanu in kakšni so odzivi na referendum tudi na severu?
Pozabljajo, da so ustali na tej strani meje, na tej strani demarkacijske črte, njihovi soborci, s katerimi so se skupaj borili proti hegemoniji, proti šariatskemu pravu, proti arabizaciji, to so Ingasane na meji z Etiopijo, pa Nube, pa seveda polovico provincije Abijeji in cel Darfur.
Vano ihna l'an tam fi marhala mifsalije, li je marhalat al-istiftaha wa taghyir al-masir. فنحن كل اللي اكدناه ان العمليه تتم بصوره سلميه
عمر بشير jasno povedal če se jih odcepi bomo čez Sudan razglasili enovito islamsko državo torej konec bo z kristijani ki tukaj prav tako živijo in seveda tudi z animisti z pogani ki častijo še vedno stare postave zato se pripravljajo na vojno In od svetovne skupnosti, od nas vseh pa zavisi, kakšni bojo, kaj se bo dogajati, le kaj zato. Pa če bomo vse čas gledali pod prste, se mogoče tisto najhujše, kar se si bojimo ne bo zgodilo.
Unlike the indigenous people in the Nuba Mountains, African natives in Blue Nile province achieve what the 2005 Comprehensive Peace Agreement stipulated, registration, people's consultations, and elections for governor, in which the SPLA rebel leader Malik Agar was elected governor of Blue Nile. Governor Malik and most people believed that Khartoum would listen to them and that there would be no war. However, like the Nuba Mountains, Blue Nile is also rich in natural resources, including gold and minerals. Furthermore, the rich and very fertile soil in Blue Nile allows mechanized farming. The exploitation of natural and particularly human resources suits the interests of the Sudanese central government, which is very reluctant to abolish slavery. So the high 80% illiteracy rate in the area suits them well. The peoples living in Blue Nile include the Uduk, Ngesena, Bati, Komo, Ganza, and many others. I gave several cameras and computers to the local people there too.
Wie einst Lily Marlin. Unsere beiden Schatten sahen wie ein aus, dass wir lieb uns hatten, das sah man gleich daran. Und alle Leute sollen es sehen, wenn wir bei der Laterne stehen. Wie einst Lily Marlin. Yeah, I'm sleeping.